Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Monday of the third week of Easter. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Good Shepherd has risen, who laid down his life for his sheep and willingly died for his flock. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that putting off our old self with its ways, we may live as Christ did, for through the healing paschal remedies, you have conformed us to his nature, who lives and reigns with the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen, filled with grace and power, was working great wonders and signs among the people. Certain members of the so-called synagogue of freedmen, Cyrenians and Alexandrians, and people from Cilicia and Asia, came forward and debated with Stephen, but they could not withstand the wisdom and the spirit with which he spoke. Then they instigated some men to say, "We have heard him speaking blasphemous words against Moses and God." They stirred up the people, the elders, and the scribes, accosted him, seized him, and brought him before the Sanhedrin. They presented false witnesses who testified, "This man never stops saying things against this holy place and the law, for we have heard him claim that this Jesus the Nazarene will destroy this place and change the customs that Moses handed down to us." All those who sat in the Sanhedrin looked intently at him and saw that his face was like the face of an angel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Though princes meet and talk against me, your servant meditates on your statutes. Yes, your decrees are my delight, they are my counselors.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
I declared my ways, and you answered me. Teach me your statutes. Make me understand the way of your precepts, and I will meditate on your wondrous deeds.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Remove from me the way of falsehood and favor me with your law. The way of truth I have chosen, I have set your ordinances before me.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus had fed the 5,000 men. His disciples saw him walking on the, After Jesus had fed the 5,000 men, his disciples saw him walking on the sea. The next day, the crowd that remained across the sea saw that there had been only one boat there and that Jesus had not gone along with his disciples in the boat, but only his disciples had left. Other boats came from Tiberias near the place where they had eaten the bread and where the Lord gave thanks. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" Jesus answered them and said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for food that endures for eternal life. For on him which the Son of Man will give you, for on him the Father God has set his seal." So they said to him, "What can we do to accomplish the works of God?" Jesus answered and said to them, This is the work of God, that you believe in the one that he sent. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today, I'd like to invite you, as the Lord is about to begin, the discourse on the bread of life. No, I'd like to invite you to reflect on our own desires and longings. No, it would be good, I think, for us to somehow constantly go back and ask ourselves, what is that longing? What is that desire that we have for Christ? No, for our relationship with Christ. No, and also part of reflecting on our desires and our longing for Christ is what motivates us. No, what motivates us to see Christ and eventually to become followers of Christ. No, and as we mentioned during the Lenten season, I was sharing with you that when we were in the seminary, we were constantly reminded, that there's no such thing as pure motivations. No, that somehow, for example, even us who decided to enter the seminary, we did not enter with 100% pure motivations or the most noble of motivations. No, but it would be good to always reflect on what is the state of our desire and our longing for Christ and our longing to have that relationship with Christ that ultimately is a relationship of a disciple, the following of Christ. No, maybe that first point to reflect on, because here the Lord confronts the people who look for him. He said, "You are not looking for me because of looking for eternal life, no, but because you had your fill, no, in the multiplication of the loaves and fish." No, so it's always good, no, to assess where are we, no, in terms of our desire and longing. No, and then the second point is the Lord telling them, no, and this is already now preparing now for the discourse on the bread of life. He said, you must work for food that endures to eternal life, no, not just for food that will satisfy us now, no, our physical hunger, but the food that will eventually bring us to eternal life, no. And here you see now that this is now the bread of life, no. This is now where the Lord now begins to talk about the bread of life, no. So the second point to reflect on, no. And he said, no, that you must work for food that endures to eternal life, no. And then after that, no, the people, no, this is not just his disciples, but the people who followed him, no, said, how do we do this, no? How are we able to work, no, for food, no, for that will endure to the bread of life? And now this brings us to the third point that I invite you to reflect on, no. How do we work? How do we do the work of God, no? Eventually, that was the answer of the Lord. The Lord said so when he says, do not work for food that perishes, but food endures eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him the Father God has set his seal. And so they said to him, the crowds asked him, what can we do to accomplish the works of God? And then Jesus answered and said to them, this is the work of God, that you believe in the one that he sent. No? So here again, you have that entire again, integration of faith and good works, no, faith and doing the works of Christ, no, and I think this is very important for us to constantly go back to this, no, that we are able to do the work of Christ because we believe in Christ, no, because of our faith in Christ. Remember, our believing in Christ really is that deepening of our relationship with him. And it is only within that relationship with Christ that we're able to do the work of Christ. No, remember, again, I go back, no, as one possible framework for reflection is what Ignatius prescribed, no, to see Christ more clearly, to love him more dearly, and that is now entering that relationship with Christ. No, and that bears fruit in the work. And what is the work? To follow Christ, no, to imitate Christ, no, in his ministry, his passion, his death and resurrection, no? Because that is the work of Christ. And one cannot do the work of Christ without believing, no, in Christ. And even I would bring it even further that in a sense, no, as I've always tell people, we become what we believe, no? And therefore, the deeper our faith in Christ, the more we're able to perform or to participate in his mission, in the work that he did. But even beyond that, the more we become Christ-like, no? Christ-like and bring that Christ-like presence into the world. Siguro maganda na pagnilaya natin ng ebanghelyo natin ngayong araw. Kasi ito nga parang introduction to sa dun sa darating na kanyang discourse on the bread of life, no? Pero makikita natin dito, yung unang punto ay, dito parang kinestyon ng Panginoon kung bakit siya hinahanap ng mga tao. So mahalaga siguro na pagnilayan natin, ano nga ba yung ating mga motibo, ano ba yung ating pagnilayan natin, ang pagnanais natin sa Panginoon na magkaroon ng ugnayan sa Kanya. Pero kasabay nito ay ano ba ang motibo natin, ano? Ng ating hangarin na mapalalim ang ating ugnayan sa Panginoon. Ano? Mahalaga na, sabi ko nga sa inunang araw, di ba, sabi sa amin sa seminaryo, wala namang 100% purong motibo na meron niyang halo palagi. Pero nga, yung paglalakbay ng panahon ng paghubog ay diyan na nabibigyan ng masasabi natin, paglilinis at pagpapagawang puro, no, ng ating motibo na maging mga alagad ng Panginoon. Ano? Tapos yung pangalawang punto ay, sabi ng Panginoon, wag kayong magtrabaho lamang sa pagkain dito sa mundo, no? Kundi magtrabaho kayo ng mga pagkain na maghahatid sa buhay na walang hanggan. Ano? At ito nga, mahalaga din natin, makita natin dito na ito yung sinasabi ng Panginoon, di ba, na yung ating gawa ang siya rin magbibigay sa atin ng daan tungo sa buhay na walang hanggan. Ano? At syempre, may tanong ulit yung crowd, tinanong, paano namin ito magagawa? No? Sabi niya, para magawa ninyo ang gustong paggawa ng Diyos, kailangan ng pananampalataya, pananalig sa Panginoon na siyang pinadala ng Diyos. At dito natin makikita ulit, ano, yung pagsasama na naman ng pananampalataya, pananampalataya sa Panginoon at ang kakayahan nating gawin ang gawa ng Panginoon. No? Sabi nga ni San Ignacio, di ba, kailangan natin, hilingin natin na higit natin makita ang Panginoon sa ating pang-araw-araw na buhay. At pagka nakita natin siya sa pang-araw-araw na buhay, ay mamahalin natin siya ng higit pa. No? So yun yung bahagi ng ugnayan natin sa Panginoon. Ano? Makita at mahalin siya, to see and to love Christ. No? At ito ay nagbubunga sa gawa. At ano yung gawa? Ang pagsunod sa Panginoon, ang pagiging disipulo ng Panginoon at gawin ang kanyang ginawa, lalo na sa pagsasakatuparan ng kanyang misyon. So, sabi nga rin natin, di ba, na kung ano ang pinaniniwalaan natin, doon din tayo na nahahalintulad. No? Na doon nagkakaroon tayo ng transformasyon na nagiging katulad tayo ng ating pinaniniwalaan. At yun ang ating pinaniniwalaan na sana ay habang patuloy tayong sumusunod sa Panginoon, ay tayong maging katulad niya, maging Christ-like sa ating mundo. So today, let us again ask the Lord, no, to grant us the grace to understand more deeply our longings and desires for Him, and that this may lead us to a deeper relationship with Him of love and fidelity, and a relationship that will make us share more deeply, no, in His mission, and ultimately for us to become Christ-like missionaries, apostles, disciples in the world. Only God the Father can satisfy the hunger of the heart and of the spirit, so we bring our needs before Him.
That the Church may awaken in her members a hunger and thirst for the bread of eternal life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may realize that the longings of the heart cannot be satisfied by the pursuit of worldly success or material comfort, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who spend their time uselessly searching for joy and happiness in the wrong way may find the right direction in life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And let's also pray that the Holy Father may continue to have good health. And let us also pray for all his intentions, especially his intentions for peace. And let's also pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for Easter.
Risen Lord, may the joy of this season inspire us to renew our friendship with you as your companions in mission. Open our mind, heart, and spirit to the truth and grace of sacred scripture, and may the story of the journey of your disciples in the early church renew our own journey of mission in our world today. Enliven our faith that we may do all things in joyful, loving obedience, and witness to the saving power of your cross and resurrection. May we be a sign of hope in our world today and bring the victory of your cross and resurrection over the evil of violence, injustice and war, over sin and death. Risen Lord, make our hearts burn within us, that we may set our world on fire with the love and mercy of your heart. Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming salamat po. And again, we'd like to invite you to consider joining the Alay Kapwa Expanded Fund Campaign. No? As every Mass, we show the QR code and also the link to be able to enroll or register as part of the Alay Kapwa Expanded Fund Campaign. The whole idea is to reach 1 million people by December of 2025, roughly around, let's say, 12 plus 8, no, the next 20 months, no, to be able to reach 1 million and help us reach 1 million people. And we just ask for an average, you know, I mean, a regular amount to give annually, no, and you can spread that out monthly or quarterly. No, but it need not be big. It could be 500 pesos a year, 1,000 pesos a year, 1,500. It really will be up to you how much you want to offer to the Alay Kapwa Expanded Fund Campaign. And this will fund all the seven legacy programs of the Alekapa Caritas Philippines. Of course, you can choose a particular program. For example, I do the work with the out of school youth. No, so you can choose and say, no, we'd like to dedicate it to the out of school youth, or we want to dedicate it to the feeding program. So please join us. And again, this is really important in making our church truly a church for and with the poor. Maraming maraming salamat po for your continued help, and let's continue to work together to become truly a very responsive church, especially in addressing the needs of our poor communities and poor brothers and sisters, not just Catholics, but all Filipinos, regardless of religion. No? Maraming pong salamat, and have a good week ahead. Thank you.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.